Dreamhouse biodigesters giving homeowners that needed peace of mind in terms of their toilet wastewater management issues through the installation of biodegradable waste biodigesters. If you are new here, subscribe for more videos like this one. In this video, we are going to talk about biodigester maintenance and what exactly we mean when we say you will have to maintain your biodigester.
So this is what has happened. Because of what has happened, it's broken, and now the top, it's falling in. I think it's because I think sort of like opened up and it fell in, and this is so it's now leaking out onto the whole place. How are you? So that's the situation with it. So this is what I was talking about. Oh. So yeah. You can see.
I've heard some installers promise people that when they install a biodigester for them, it will last as much and as long as 20, 30 years. What I've always advised is that whenever you are going to install a biodigester, and I'm the one that's going to advise you, what I explain to you is, even though it's different from septic tanks or culverts, what septic tanks and culverts need is to have them dislodged. When it comes to biodigesters, what we have is maintenance. Your biodigester has to be maintained for the lifespan in which you want it to last. So I have a few people who call me or who want to inquire about biodigesters call me, and they want to know the lifespan of a digester. The reason is simple, because they've been told that when they construct a biodigester, it will last them 20 or 30 years. And then they want to know whether I also promise the same. I cannot promise you a biodigester will last you that much. What I can promise you is that biodigesters, when you do install them, you will need to have them maintained periodically. Periodic maintenance is needed for biodigesters in the sense that, same as a septic tank or a culvert will need to be dislodged, a biodigester will also have to be maintained for it to last that much for you. So if you intend on installing a biodigester, there are a few things that you need to know, and one of them is that maintenance has to be done. And what exactly do we mean when we say biodigester maintenance? That's exactly what we are going to talk about in this video. If you are new here, subscribe for more videos like this one. So there are a few things you have to consider in case you want to install a biodigester. Usually, whoever intends to install a biodigester for a client will have to tell them the do's and don'ts of biodigesters. One of the key parts is that biodigesters are biodegradable waste biodigesters, which are supposed to help aid in biodegradation and decomposition of human solid waste. Unlike the septic tank or the culverts that keeps the waste together and stores it for a certain number of months or years before it's physically removed through dislodging, digesters are supposed to decompose the human waste and then it's for easy disposal. What most people also fail to say is that there are certain things that must be done when it comes to installing biodigesters. What I mean is there are some do's and don'ts when it comes to biodigesters. What are the do's? The do's are that you are allowed to flush your units as usual, as it's supposed to be. Anything organic, like your tissue paper and the human waste, are good for the biodigesters. What is not good, and the don'ts, as I put them, is the inorganic materials, which includes the diapers, the pampers, anything that cannot break down by the digester. So when it comes to this issue, what we say is a time will come, depending on the lifestyle of the homeowner or the family who have installed a biodigester, a maintenance have to be done. And the reason why the maintenance lifespan cannot be determined, or the time range in which maintenance must be done cannot be determined, is solely and mainly based on the family's lifestyle. So if there's a family of five and they're living in a three-bedroom house, you have your three children with you, you have father, mother, probably there's a house help, or there's grandmother also staying with us, then what we are going to do, or the estimate that must usually be made, is that this digester must last you at least 5 years before maintenance is done. if it does not last you that amount of time, then what it means is that probably some inorganic materials might have mixed with the organic ones in the digester, and it's going to prevent the digester from doing what it's supposed to do, which is to biodegrade the solid waste. Whenever there's an inorganic material in a digester, the microorganisms and the macroorganisms that is in decomposition cannot work well, because then it means that they block the pores, they block the oxygen that comes into the septic or into the digester tank, and they prevent the digester from working as it's supposed to. In that case, you will need to have maintenance done. So if there's a qualified installer who has installed a digester for you and you experience such a problem, what you do is to call the installers to come and have the lid of the digester open up, and then all those stuffs that are in it can physically be removed out. So if there's pampers, there's diapers, there's cigarette butts and all those stuffs, naturally those things are not going to biodegrade. So you have to remove. That's where the maintenance issue comes in for biodigesters. So what are the steps that we take when it comes to maintenance? First thing, if you get to realize your digester is getting full, usually happens when you flush the flush unit or the WC, you realize that there's a bubbles, and then it settles. It takes time before you can settle into the digester tank. Then there are some occasions you might also see the water outside around the tank showing, and that is overflowing. In that case, it means that maintenance has to be done. Either the soak away or the soak hole pit is not working well, or some materials that cannot biodegrade have gone to block the pores or the pipes, or have clogged the way in which the water must go into the soak away for the digester bed to work well. The key part for most homeowners that they need to know is that when you are using a biodigester, there shouldn't be a water or there shouldn't be any water in the digester bed, because it works well when it's dry, and the microorganisms work well when there's no water in the digester. That's why in the previous video that we explained about biodigesters, we said that there must be a rapid separation of the solid waste from the water. The solid waste stays in the digester, microorganisms work on it, the water goes through the leche pipe into the soak away or the soak hole pit, or into a gutter or whatever system that you are using for the water treatment. If they are not going to work well, then you have to do maintenance. It means that the digester bed will have to be changed, new ones will have to be fitted. The good news for homeowners now is, when we started doing these biodigesters, we were using wire mesh, the mosquito netting, and then some other stuffs. What happens with this technology was that it was corroding because of the water, the acidic nature of the water from the flush unit was corroding the wire mesh and the nets. And then the time range or the timelines in which maintenance has to be done will be shorter, right? But luckily with the new improved biodigesters, which have got the porous system, and then the filtration is way, way, way better, you don't have that problem unless it's really the lifestyle of the family who are living in the house. How do we do maintenance? When you call us, there's a problem with your biodigester. Either the top slab has broken and the water has seeped into the digester.
You can see from this side, I don't say. Like, you can actually see that it's like there's a leak here. There's a leak on this side. Oh, it's as a beer. A beer what this side, no? And then, yeah, I had a moon in a, you know, I did not sleep at home. I don't know how it happened. But there was no impact, and yes, we be a grow or so, and all that. Nothing like that. Just like that. Yeah.
Or it's not working well, or you can smell something, or you can see something outside the digester tank, and you give the installer a call. When the installer shows up there, they are going to take the lid off. They are going to check the soak hole to see if it's still soaking water as supposed to. Or they will check the leche pipe to see if the pipe water, the wastewater is going where it's supposed to go. When it comes to the digester bed, what we do basically is to take the digester bed out. If it's porous that was laid, all the remains that will have gotten stuck on the porous bed will be taken out, including the net or the fiber net on it will have been taken out, and then the new materials will be laid. A new net will have to be laid. You also check to see if the porous has lost its firmness, then probably you have to change that one as well. But if it's still firm, it's only the fiber net that will have to be changed, and then new coconut husk or hay or fiber or anything that you use for the digester bed will just have to be laid, and then it can be sold back for use. So basically, that's the maintenance that you do for biodigesters. That's why we say with biodigesters, your peace of mind is assured. One of the reasons is that maintenance, unless it's really a big problem, it shouldn't take an installer more than 30 minutes or 1 hour to do maintenance, and then you are back to using your digester as it's supposed to be. Unless there's a problem with the soakaway, which means that a different soakaway will have to be dug, or the first soakaway has got a problem, and then the second soakaway will have to be dug for another pipe to be connected from the other side into the digester, then that's where then it might take you an hour or two to have the maintenance done. But if it's only a problem with the bed in terms of the biodegradable materials, or there are some stuffs, inorganic materials that die in the digester, it's really a short period, and then it can be done, and then you are back to using your digester. This is Dreamhouse Biodigesters. If you are new to this channel, consider subscribing for videos like this that explains how these biodegradable waste biodigesters work. Subscribe to this channel. We are very active on Instagram at Dreamhouse Biodigesters. Our website, dreamhousebiodigesters.com, is also active. You can go there and check some of our videos and the type of biodigesters that we have for homeowners. Thank you so much for watching this video. Until next time, bye-bye.